So basically, state medical councils, okay, they can take disciplinary action over registered medical practitioners. So they have disciplinary control over them. So if there is an infamous conduct, what punishment can be given? So there is a diagram here. If you want, you can look at that. Basically here, let us say disciplinary action by state medical council for any negligence, okay, any complaint basically. It can be infamous conduct or medical negligence, okay. Please see here. So if there is a conviction by court, let's use red here. If there's conviction by court or if there's a complaint by public or an official complaint, so there is a registrar of state medical council who maintains the registered medical practitioners list, right? So then there is a precedent, there is a special subcommittee. Now the doctor is summoned and there is an inquiry conducted. Then there is a, they would have to take a decision on it. If there is negligence or something like that, there is a disciplinary committee. Then either they will give a acquittal, that means that person is not at all charged, he is absolutely right. Okay, so let's make that green weight. Please make it green. So basically he is acquitted. Then otherwise there can be a warning given to him. Okay. Then there can be suspension or there can be penal eraser. That is, I am thinking that his registration is not considered anymore. The doctor after this can appeal to the MCI. Or the central government. Okay. So basically just understand here. Just look at the diagram and try to understand again. So basically, if it is brought to the notice of the council and if it finds prima facie an error against the doctor, okay, what they have written here. Notice is served specifying the nature and particulars of charges and he has to answer these charges in writing, the doctor, and he has to attend before the council on the appointed day. After hearing, okay, there should be, the medical practitioner should be there and possibly his lawyer can be there. After hearing both the parties, a vote is taken and they are going to prove if they can prove the charges. They have to decide the punishment. And the punishment, guys, wake up, I know I am reading from the textbook. So, basic, there can be warning or suspension or penal erasure. Okay, if he is wrong. So, what is a warning notice, they will ask, okay, in the exam. They ask, what is warning notice, remember? The state medical council can issue warning notices to practitioners found violating standards of professional conduct and code of ethics. So they can give warning. That is a warning notice. Okay. So this is what you have seen as disciplinary action by state medical council. Okay. So remember there will be a registrar here. Who will be there in state council, medical council? There is a registrar. Okay. And in state medical council some documents are maintained. There is a register of medical practitioners in the state, okay, the name, the residence, the qualification, all that information will be maintained. So all this rural service, internship, all that is managed by these people only. Guys, now that we are here in this, now just let's look off also who and all will be there in state medical council. There can be medical teachers, okay, that is, you can say doctors, the registered medical practitioners can be there, teachers can be there, some members nominated by the government also can be there. Okay, then the office bearers, there will be what and all posts will be there, a registrar, president, vice president, all these people can be there. Okay, executive panel, lot of things, executive committee, all that can be there in state medical council. So in this video we have finished about state medical council and also we have finished the disciplinary action against negligence of a doctor. Okay. That's all for now. Bye-bye.